Hi guys, today we will be unboxing the StarSense Explorer 114LT telescope. This is one of the telescopes from the StarSense series of Celestron launched just a few years ago. In this video, we will unbox the telescope, assemble it, align it, and also see the celestial objects. I will also let you know what the pros and cons of this telescope are. If you buy this telescope, you can follow this video to assemble your telescope. Okay, let's open the telescope. The telescope was very well and efficiently packed in three different boxes. One box is for optical tube assembly, one box is for tripod and accessory tray, and one box is for the eyepieces and accessories. You get the manual for setting up the telescope along with some other information about how to register your telescope on Celestron's website and instructions to download Celestron's Sky Portal app. You will also get the code for the StarSense app, without which you cannot use the telescope with your phone. Let's open the optical tube assembly. This is the optical tube. And that antenna-like part is the altitude rod for adjusting the vertical motion of your telescope. The aperture of this optical tube is 114 mm. Its focal length is 1000 mm and its focal ratio is 9. Notice that the focal ratio is 9, which means the telescope is mostly suitable for the moon and planets. If you don't know what I am talking about, then you need to watch this video on the channel. The weight of this optical tube assembly is 6.5 pounds or around 3 kilograms. It is very easy for any adult to carry and move this telescope around. The accessories box has a bunch of accessories and eyepieces. This is a StarSense smartphone dock to mount your smartphone, which is the whole point of this StarSense series. Then you get a 10mm eyepiece, one 25mm eyepiece, one 2x Barlow lens. The Barlow lens is lightweight and is made up of plastic. Then we have a red dot finder and its base to fix it on the telescope, and a knob to adjust the altitude of the telescope. The tripod box had a tripod and an accessory tray. The quality of the tripod is just good enough and it can easily handle the weight of the optical tube assembly. The height of the tripod can be raised up to 4.5 feet. Now let's assemble the telescope. First, we will attach the accessory tray. On the side of this yoke mount, this part is an altitude rod guider. Just loosely fix the knob from the accessory box on the guider. The next step is to fix the optical tube assembly on the mount. As per the manual that came with the telescope, it said you have to hold the optical tube like this and precisely guide the altitude rod through this guider. I tried it couple of times, but the hole in the guider was very tight and I wasn't able to fix it this way. I thought I might drop the optical tube while fixing this, so I removed this screw and separated the altitude rod from the optical tube assembly. Then I individually fixed it on the guider. Now fix the optical tube assembly on the mount and adjust the altitude rod guider to fix it to the optical tube assembly. With this, you have successfully assembled your main telescope. Next, it's time to assemble the remaining accessories. First is the finder scope. Remove these screws and fix the finder scope base. Then just slide the finder scope onto the base and you are done. Next is fixing the eyepieces. It is easy. Just remove the dust cap and put the eyepiece in. The last step is to install the StarSense smartphone dock. It is very easy. Just loosen these two screws on the dock mount. Slide your smartphone dock into the dock mount and tighten the screws. To mount your phone, remove the cover from the dock first. It is made up of flexible plastic, so there is no chance that you will break it. There is a mirror under this cover. You have to put your phone's camera lens exactly above this mirror. it is possible that your phone's camera might not be in the exact center. It might be on the left or right side of your phone. So you can use this knob below the smartphone dock to adjust your phone's camera alignment with the mirror of the dock. Now your telescope is fully assembled. Just remove the lens cap and you are ready to observe. The next part is aligning the telescope. For this, you have to take your telescope outside during the daytime. The first thing you have to do is to remove this small plastic strip that is placed inside the finder scope. It was given so that the finder scope battery wouldn't discharge. Now turn on the finder scope. This knob on the finder scope is to turn it on and off. You can also increase and decrease the intensity of the red dot with this knob. These two knobs are for adjusting the red dot in the finder scope. Now let's align this telescope. First, put your 25mm eyepiece in the eyepiece holder. Find any object which is around 500 meters and easily visible. In my case, I focused on this TV satellite dish. Next, you have to move the red dot onto the object your telescope is focusing on. I pointed it at the satellite dish my telescope was focusing on. Once you do that, your telescope is aligned. With this alignment, you can use your telescope manually. All you have to do is to point the red dot at any object in the sky and it will be visible through your eyepiece. But this is a StarSense telescope. So you want to use the StarSense app with this telescope. For that, you need to set up the StarSense app for your telescope. This is very easy. All you have to do is to mount your phone on the telescope and start the StarSense app. You will get an option to align it. Then point your telescope at the sky and the app will detect the location of your telescope. It will tell you to align any object visible through the eyepiece with the crosshair on the screen. Align the object once and you are done. Next, you can search for any object you want and click on locate. The StarSense will guide you to that object. Once you reach your target, it will turn green and will be visible through the eyepiece. Now let's see how objects look through this telescope. Let's see the pros and cons of this telescope. The pros are, this telescope is very lightweight and very easy to use. The instructions to assemble the telescope are clear and very easy to follow. You can also follow this video to assemble your telescope. The biggest pro for this telescope for beginners is the cost. You get many features for the price you pay for. The best thing about this telescope is the StarSense app. With the help of the app, you don't really need to worry about knowing the sky. All you have to do is put the object you want in the search and the StarSense will guide you to your target. Any beginner can start looking at the celestial object just within a few minutes. I used the StarSense app to track the green comet just the day before yesterday. It is so easy and so much fun to explore the sky with the StarSense app. Anyways, let's see the negatives of this telescope. The eyepieces you get with this telescope are the Kellner eyepieces. Plossel eyepieces are usually better. The Barlow lens you get with this telescope is made of plastic and is just unusable. This telescope doesn't have a slow knob for horizontal motion. However, its counterpart and a little bit more expensive telescope, the StarSense 130DX, have slow knobs for both altitude and azimuth movement. Overall, the telescope is specifically targeted towards the beginners and is only suitable for visual astronomy. Dedicated astrophotography with this telescope is not possible, but you can click photos with the help of your phone. You will need a phone mount like this. As your first telescope, it is a good telescope. It will definitely get you excited about astronomy. You will be excited to look at different objects, and with the StarSense app, it is easy and much more fun to explore the night sky. So instead of buying those extreme beginner telescopes, which are most likely only good for watching the moon once or twice, this telescope can be a good choice. And it does the job the money you pay for. If you want your kids or your loved ones to get interested in astronomy, then this telescope can be a great option to gift someone to get them started. If you have a more budget, then a bigger StarSense 130DX from the StarSense series will also be a good choice. If you have an even higher budget, then you can never go wrong with the Nexstar 6SE or the Nexstar 8SE. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, then give it a like and subscribe to the channel for more such content.